You guys should have all received in your packet this afternoon, or in your mailboxes this afternoon, a packet from me. It's basically contains the final purchase order list for 2017. I had come in, I think, 2 weeks ago and kind of started to lay the groundwork for what we were going to be bringing forward. We have since paid a lot of 2017 bills, so I've been able to reduce it. I think the purchase order list when I was first here was like 800 and something. Now it's down to $589,244.53. So we're still seeing 17 bills come in, and those are getting processed. So the first sheet breaks down the purchase orders. Like I said, there's $589,244.53. Of that amount, though, $236,529 is from Fund 27 for the new ambulance. So we're looking to bring forward from the general fund, the $352,715.53. And then underneath that, there's a breakdown of all the warrant articles and their balances as of 12/31 of 2017. I can read through them all if you guys would like. There's quite a lengthy list. It totals $1,713,781. I put all the lapse dates there for all the non-lapsing articles, so you can see that they are still articles that haven't lapsed and can be brought forward into the new fiscal year. So you're looking at $2,003,901.53 of carry forwards. The largest ones there are preliminary design revitalization at $297,000, and then $533,000 for the Grist Mill Pond Dam, and $613,212 for Lafayette Road. But that is going to end up, now that it was bonded in January, we'll end up running that through as a bond. But since the bond sale didn't take place until January, we were tracking all the expenditures just through the warrant article. So that will come back into like a due from account. And I also did point out on here that there were three different warrant articles that did lapse or are finished, and so the money will go back into the unassigned fund balance. One of them was Article 24 from 2016 for a utility revaluation of $150,000. Article 26 from 2016 for a recreation infrastructure at $5,598. And Article 23 from 2017 for household hazardous waste at $5,874. So that will go back to the unassigned fund balance. So I don't know if you guys have questions on that. You also had the purchase order list. Fred and I have been through it with department heads and stuff. So,
Regina?
So just clarification. So the $352,000, that probably is going to continue to change a little bit because you're still paying 17 bills.
No, that will be the final number because the board has to vote to bring forward a number. So now any 17 purchase orders that come in, and any bills that were from 17 related to purchase orders will be processed in 18 against the purchase orders.
Okay.
But that's why it's dropped since I was here the last time for that exact reason that you just gave, though. So okay. We are still running like 17 batches. Now we need to move forward.
So that's right in with the estimate you had, right?
Right.
Yep. All right, great. Very good job. Thank you.
Rusty?
All set. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Mm-hmm. Negative. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Thank you, Director.
How does that compare to other years, the amount we're
carrying? Right in there. Right. I think last year was 500 and something also. I don't know how much was from other funds last year, though. But I think it's right in line with prior years for the purchase order carry forward, yes.
Okay. Thank you.
So,
we need a vote on that?
Yes, sir, you do.
On separately on each one or?
You do it collectively.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
Okay, all in favor? Opposed? Good.
And I also just want to point out, I did not generate my final end of year financials because we have a couple more bills that I wanted to run through this week. So prior to the deliberative, because I know a lot of people out there have been asking and looking for them, by the end of this week, I will be issuing my unaudited 2017 financials. So I will email those to you and put them on the website prior to the deliberative on Saturday.
Great, thank you.
So, a little heads up there. And I did, on preliminary look, it looks like we're going to have about $270,000 in under expenditures and about 300 and $90,000 in revenues that were higher than what we had estimated at the time of the tax rate setting. So those are just to give you guys an idea of where we are at. So.
Very good.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.